About 13 years ago, one of my daughters was born. Her name is Isabella. We call her Belle. It was, of course, a fantastic moment in my life, and I reached out to an old friend of mine, the late, great Phill Hartsfield, to make me a very special sword. There would be a sword that was basically the culmination of everything that I had gotten from Kendo and the Aido and all the different things I did, a sword built exactly to my specs. At the time, I had owned and still own a full Katana Walk set from Phill, and it's fantastic. But I wanted something special to celebrate my daughter, and also a piece that would really represent everything that I wanted out of a sword. At the time, about, like I said, 13 years ago, Phill was not really doing many swords. His son was just coming in the shop, and this piece probably could be one of the last sole authorship katanas from Phill Hartsfield. Phill was a very special person to me. I was a troubled youth, and Phill spent a lot of time on the phone with me. I originally had made my pilgrimage out there when I was about 19. I went into Phil's shop. I couldn't afford anything. You've all heard the story about the Quakens, and he sold me a Quaken for what I had in my pocket, and I looked at the katana he had on the stand there, and it was a dream. At the time, Phill had the catalog out with the eagle as a Manuki, and it was just, that sword symbolized everything I ever wanted in a katana. It was, you know, he was the father of the modern day interpretation of the Japanese classic blade. He really took what the Japanese were doing in ancient times and kind of rolled it into what he thought the Japanese blade would have evolved to if it was still used on the battlefield. Like I said, this sword means a lot to me. First off, because it's probably one of the last katanas my friend did on his own. It commemorates the birth of my daughter, Belle, and it is the most wicked blade I've ever played with. Over the years of doing Kendo, I got used to a longer Tsuka, a handle. I don't like 11-inch handles. I believe I can get more power and more stroke with my hands further apart. My tip moves faster, better leverage for me. So this is a 13-plus inch Tsuka. Brown Ito, black ray skin, and dragonfly Manukis that I sent Phill. The dragonfly means a lot to me. On my back, there's a lot of Japanese type tattoos. There's three dragonflies on my back with all three of my daughter's names tattooed in it. I have a boat named Dragonfly. It's just always been I have a sword named TONBOKIRI, which is Dragonfly Cutter. To me, this is TONBOKIRI, Dragonfly Cutter. Of course, it's done in one of Phill's aluminum sayas, wrapped with ostrich skin. Again, the blade was made to my specs. It's 26 inches. You can see it. It's A2. Phill did his classic temper line, subtle wave. To this day, people still don't know how Phill really did his A2 temper lines. All we do know is that they are, you know, far from a piece of art when it comes to modern day, if you look at art temper lines, Phill's were not that. They were a milky white line that ran down the blade that did show it was edge hardened. But nothing cuts like a Hartsfield katana. I've cut with a ton of blades, and from old blades to modern adaptations of the Japanese cutlery down to traditional geometry blades, no katana cuts like a Phill Hartsfield katana. It's a privilege to be the caretaker of this sword, and I hope my kids will always cherish it. I've had other swords commissioned on different kids' birthdays. I hope each child takes the sword. In a way, I'd like to be buried with this one because it means so much to me, but I'd rather she not stick it in the hole. I'd rather Belle keeps this sword and cherishes it. Again, it is a true masterpiece. It's the finest katana when it comes to all-out war katana that I've ever had the privilege of playing with and owning. It is truly a magnificent piece. Again, a homage piece to my daughter, the late, great Phill Hartsfield, and to all you katana lovers out there, I believe, the baddest sword in all the land. Thanks.